everybody. As the word says in Psalms 143 verse 8, let the morning bring a word of your unfailing love. For I have put my trust in you, showing me the way I should go. For you, I entrust my life. I entrust my life to the Lord. Let us remember that we entrust our life to the Lord.
Amen.
Every morning and before we go to bed, God should be at the center.
Amen.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain. So the song says there is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain. Do you understand that? That is deep. To break every chain. There is no chain that Jesus cannot break today.
Amen.
You need to wake up this morning.
Wakey, wakey.
Jesus is your chain breaker.
Hallelujah.
And he will break any chain. Nothing is too small for him. Because in the name of Jesus, there is power. There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. To break every chain. To break every chain. To break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain. As Christians, we should rise up. We should be that army of God. You passing by as a Christian, and you are not spreading the good news of Jesus, is so sad and it's heartbreaking. You should be out there in the streets spreading the good news of Jesus. This is a time where people need to open their eyes and see that God is good.
Amen.
Let's sing. Jesus at the center of it all. And Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus, you, Jesus, be the center of my life. Jesus, be the center of my life. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, nothing else matters, nothing in this world will do, cause Jesus, you're the center, and everything revolves around you, Jesus, you. From the heart to the heaven, Jesus, Jesus should be the center of everything.
Hallelujah.
Your life, your ministry, your marriage, your children, he should be at the center. Because if Jesus is in the center, you're going to crumble. Because he's the only firm foundation
he crumbles.
That you can stand in. Let's not forget that. Sometimes during this situation, you may feel like you're lost and lonely, that things are not going well. But just remember, God says it is well.
Amen.
So listen. Grand Arab was quickly fall. Moved by the sound of his voice. The season now was shaken and stirred. We'll be calm and broken for my regard. Sing that again. And through it all, my eyes are on, and it is well, it is well. So let go my soul and trust in him. The words and wings still hold his name. So let go. Still know his name. The waves and wind still know his name. It is well. It is well with my soul. It is well.
Let's remember, hallelujah.
It's well with our soul.
Amen.
Keep our eyes on Jesus. That's the only way. He is the only way which you keep your soul well. Let's not forget that. It is well. It is well with my soul.
Praise Amen.
God. I hope today your soul will be well, and that your soul awakens and remembers that Jesus is in control. Amen.
Amen.
Brother, lead us in some more fire.
Amen. 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 God bless you.
Lord Jesus. Praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen. So today we have to preach to you and for the Lord Intercessor Ministries, hoping that some of you will give your life to Jesus Christ today. Amen. Now my message for you today is very appropriate for me to give that message is about what? Character. Character matters most in this life, you see. As we are moving away from 2020 and tomorrow we're going to move to 2021, I want you to give me all your own characters of 2020. Amen. I want you today to come and give your life to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you to today about character. You see, because some of you thinking that you have tomorrow to live. Let me tell you something. Tomorrow may never come for some of us.
Amen.
It is what it is. Amen. I can change it. You can change it. You see? So we have to do what? Have this decided factor in our mind. Know that tomorrow can never come for some of us. Even though tomorrow is New Year's Day. So today, that's what I'm preaching to you. Because the Bible says, today is the day of what? Salvation. You see? So your character matters more. You see, for some of you, your character is like the opposite of beatitude. Blessed are those only first seekers. And then I will be blessed. You see? It doesn't work like that, you see. So today I want to preach you that if you come to know Christ, Jesus Christ today, I want you to have a Christian character. Amen? Not the worldly character. Today I want you to have what? A Christian character, you see. Because you have to know this, when you are being saved, when you give your life to Jesus Christ, there's a character that God has to build in you. Amen? There's a character God has to build in you. You see? Those scales have to be shipped off from you, you see? And that is why today I want you to give your life to Jesus Christ so that you can have the true character that God wants you to have. Amen? So one thing I want you to notice today also is this. I want you to listen to what the Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 3. This is the way God built up his character, amen? So he said, rejoice in your suffering. You get that? He said, rejoice in your suffering. And then say, knowing that your suffering produces patience, and patience produces character, and character produces hope. And hope that you have does not fear of the not because of the why? Because God has poured out his love into our heart through the Holy Spirit. Amen? So, just like this is what today that I make. Some of you have a New Year resolution already. You're going to say, I'm going to stop eating this, I'm going to stop doing that. That's all well and fine. The physical side of it, you can do for yourself. But the spiritual side of it, let me tell you something. How is it working out well? The ones you have made last year, and we are coming to this end. Have you kept all of them? Do you remember them? That is why today I want you to do what? To be born again. Amen? I was thinking about it this morning. I said, okay, I myself, I want to make some changes. And then Spirit of God telling me, he makes changes. And then, what a wonderful thing that is Spirit of God. I want to make some changes, you see, because at some point, you need to kind of look into your life. You want to improve, you see. And you have to remember what the Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. He said, he who began a good work in you will do what? Bring you to work to completion. Amen? So I know that it's only through the power of the Holy Spirit if you want to have a Christian character. Not the worldly character. You see, because the Christian character, no one can teach you, your pastor can teach you that. Is the Holy Spirit, only God. And only when you can have a Christian character is when you be born again. When you give your heart, your mind, your soul, your spirit, your personality, everything to the hand of God, and then let God move you. I mean, remember when God sent the man of God to go and see how the body pray. And then you see the potter house, how it's molding, the same way today. If you try to mold your lifestyle, you try to mold your character without God, you're gonna fail.
Amen.
So many of you are going back to your old ways.
Amen.
You continue doing the same thing today, you try again. Some days you are happy, some days you are sad, and some days you laugh, you smile, then you come again, you run back again. It's like a back and forth, it's like a cycle. You see? And that is why today I'm pushing for you to do what? To give your life to Jesus Christ, you see? Because only Jesus Christ can give you that, can develop that character. I'm not a foolish article. She's not a foolish article. None of us are. That's why the Bible said that he began a good work in you. He said he will bring you to completion of
Amen.
The of Christ. So that means, as you are working out your life, as you are working out your Christian lifestyle, you need to give it to the hands of God. Because why? God continues to work you. And then God continues to do what? To shape your lifestyle. And when the Bible says clearly, I mean, for me, I need to understand it. You see, because the word of God is so true. He said, you judge for your suffering. That is God that you are serving. So if you are a Christian, you are not immune from suffering. I want you to understand this. I mean, look at the life of Aaron. Aaron has stressed to do what he gave. To get Moses. I mean, go to the people, go to the tree. They build up their muscle. They do everything to do what their muscle is expanding. The same way to the deep trials and temptations, we are able to make it to the kingdom of God. So the mountain, when you come to meet Jesus Christ, everything is our life. Honey, we have no beach, no way. It doesn't come right like the same. And that's why today I want you to give your life to Jesus Christ, you see. Because the Bible says it's not that your son produces passion. That's the key point. We produce one person, other persons, you say, endurance, perseverance. You see, then again, he said that person produces character. And that's why I'm pushing you to that character, you see. Because character is important. Because some of the character that you have today is not the character that God wants you to have. You see? So I want you today to get rid of all the character of 2020. As soon as I'm moving to 2021, I want you to give your life to Jesus Christ. I want Jesus Christ to build up your character, you see? Because he said that character produces your hope. And then he said that the hope that you have in God, you will not fail out. You see, and that is why I cannot produce you, because I know if you put your hope in God, this only one cannot pay you. You can tell me, I can tell you, we can tell each other. But the Bible says our God is a covenant to be God. In fact, the Bible says that all the word of God in the Bible, the 66 book, is what is yes and amen in Christ Jesus. Amen. So that is why today I want you to know one thing. I mean, we as a soldier, what do we do? It's not come train and then at some point they have to go to war. There's no point to train if they don't go to war. You understand what I mean? And the same way today, even a sailor have to also do all this so that he can go on his own son. You see, so in all these things, you need to know one thing. That's what to build up a character in you. And that character is a different character, it's not the one different character. Because this kind of character, they cannot teach you what in the school, you see. And to have this decent character, I have 5 steps that I'm going to give to you. And I'm for you to follow. And all this coming from what? The book of Romans chapter 5. And I just repeat that verse 3. For you to do what? To pray. Because the Bible has given us guidelines. You have already told us, you say what? You say you produce what? Faith. You produce what? Patience. You produce what? Good character. You produce what? Endurance, perseverance, hope. And that hope that you have in Jesus Christ will never fail you, see? So the first step I want to give you today for you to bear in mind is for you to do what? To allow pressure. Amen? The Bible just said it. He said what? He said rejoice in your suffering. So that means you need to accept God today that pressure is going to come and squeeze you to see that you can be made of God. You see, sometimes people come and tell me that Christian, then again, I want to see the fruit be producing from you. You see, when I shake you, I want to see that fruit that the Bible has said that you need to do what to produce, you see. And that is why today, God allow trials. In fact, sometimes long suffering. Sometimes you have to persevere. Sometimes you have to endure. And you think God will not love you. Of course, God loves you. But then again, God needs to train you out. You see, when I have a Christian character, what the first thing you need to do, you need to submit to Jesus Christ. Amen. You need to give your life to Jesus Christ. There's no point trying to build up a character if you don't have the solid foundation. And that foundation is Jesus Christ. So that means any character you try to produce today in your lifestyle, any of your New Year resolution, if Christ is not included, I will tell you today, forget about it. Because when you come back to the end of 2021, we're going to find out that you fear again, just as you've been praying for many years, without Jesus Christ, you see. So for you to have a character today, is to have Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ will give that character in your life. Okay? That's why the Bible says, look at Romans chapter 5, verse 3. It says, not only that, it says, but rejoice in your suffering. Amen. So my friends, my brothers and sisters, the Bible says rejoice, you see. So I want you today to allow God to apply that pressure in you, you see, to see that if you can sustain it, because when you come out from it, the Bible says you will see the crime. So that means, for example, I don't know what you like, whatever that you like, you're going to be tempted through that. The Bible says, God can never tempt us, you see. But whatever your heart desire, it is God will allow the devil to go there and test you to see if your faith is real. You see, a lot of hypocrite people, a lot of people pretending to be Christians, and then at the when they're afraid of being tested, and then you can find out what they're being made of, and then for some reason, you see that they withdraw from God, and they get upset. I mean, you have to remember when Joshua said that, do not be offended by him. He said, when you go into trials and tribulations, in fact, the Bible says that through trials and tribulations, that you can make it into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Amen. So if you're not going through that, I'm going to tell you today, you need to examine your faith. You need to examine your faith. Maybe you're on the wrong path, you're on the wrong road. You are not in the straight line, you see? And that is why today, my friends, are you having any trouble right now? Are you having any trouble? Are you having a hard time? Are you feeling the heat? Are you feeling the pressure? You see, my friends, all those obstacles is to do what? Don't see them as an obstacle anymore. I want you to see them as an opportunity. Your faith must be tested. Faith not tested is not faith at all. Amen? Character that is not being tested, God bless you, man, is not being tested at all. You see, God is going to try you. And then God is going to put that pressure. And then you put it in this way. When you have the grapes, what do you do? You put pressure on them so that I can squeeze something out. The same way God is going to squeeze you. He's going to squeeze you with taste. He's going to squeeze you with pressure. And I want you today to do what? To allow it. Are you going through that pressure right now? As a child of God, do not have a way out. You see? You know why? Because the Bible says that God measures each one of us according to our faith and give us what he can able to test us to see what we are being made of, you see? And that is why today I'm telling you to do what? To see it as an opportunity, because you want to build up a Christian character, your faith need to do what? To be tested. You see, when it comes to the worldly character, you're already in the camp of devil. I mean, devil continue to use you and dump you, use that and dump you, you see? But if you come to Jesus Christ, the Bible says that the godly sorrow leads to what? Leads to repentance, you see? But the worldly sorrow leads to what? Leads to death, you see? So God has to train us. Amen. If you ask yourself, look at your life and see how far you've been going. Are you going in a straight line or are you walking in a zigzag? You know yourself, you see? And that is what I'm telling you today. Forget about all your New Year resolution if you do not include Jesus Christ, you see? Because the Bible says, through trials and tribulations, my dear friends, we can make it into the kingdom of Almighty God, you see? So allow that prayer to go through, you see? Sometimes people will come and tell me it is their luck. I say, no. In the Bible, there's no anywhere concept about luck. The Bible said that all things work out together for those that love God and are come to their own purpose. You see? So for that about luck and faith, it doesn't work in the kingdom of God. You see, today I want you to build up a character. I want you to allow Jesus Christ to come inside your heart. He wants to dwell in your heart. He wants to guide you. He wants to lead you, just as a father leads his son, you see? So today, you have to make that choice today. I want you to listen, you see? Whatever you're going through right now, just know that God already knows, you see? Because when all said and done, God gonna build it up, you see? Because I'm talking about Christian faith, you see? If you are being saved, you need to have that solid foundation. And that foundation should be what? Be cemented. You have to do what? Be rooted in Jesus Christ. Amen? And that is why the Bible said that. By the way, it said that for you to build up your faith, he said you need to do what? You need to go through suffering. Amen? He said when you go through that suffering, he said rejoice. So that means you don't want you to complain. Amen? And that's God we are serving, you see? Because how is he going to trust you if your faith is not being tested, you see? And that is why you see many people today, they come to Christian life, they think they won't be tested. Let me tell you something. Whether you're a Christian life or not, even if outside Christian life, you're going to go through trials. Amen? You're going to see yourself some days, you have sorrows. Amen? You name it. You know? So in all these things, God is trying to do what? To build it up. And that is why I'm telling you, your first thing that you need to do, friends, is to do what? To receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Because when all said and done, just as I told you before, you can't just expect all the honey without no bees.
Amen.
If you come to Jesus Christ, you're going to expect the whole packet. You're going to expect sorrow. You're going to expect the day some days you laugh. Some days you weep like a baby. Some days you rejoice. In all these things, he's training you up. He wants to do what? To get you to mature, to come to the place where he wants you to be. Amen? You ask yourself this, amen? And there is any gospel that is in the word of God, there's no adversity, there's no misfortune, there's no persecution, there's no pain, there's no sickness, there's no sorrow, there's no mourn, there's no groan. You need to ask yourself, what kind of church are you going? What kind of Christian lifestyle do you have? If you are just driving around, you put your gear on the cruise control, it's just like cruising. There's no bumps in your life. There's no bumps. There's no traffic. Then you're just driving in the motorway. You're on a highway. You're just driving. Your life is so easy. You need to check your faith again because your faith must be tested. Amen? Your faith has to be tested, you see? God wants to see what you have been made of. You see, whether you're made of wood or you're made of what? Gold. Amen. And that is why I'm telling you today. You need to allow that pressure to come in, you see, because that pressure will build you up, you see, and that pressure will lead you to know who Jesus Christ is, and that pressure will lead you to eternal life, you see, because the Bible says he who began a good work in your life will do what? Will bring it to the control, to bring it to perfection, you see. So, my dear friends, you see any singers. If you see them when they're singing, if they're not singing from their heart, you will know it. You see, God have to do what? To break you. And then that's why he said to the man of God to go to the potter's house, and he cracked the whole thing. And then you look at the life of Moses. He was broken. He killed a man. He did all this. He ran away. God let him just forget about him for 40 years and just keep working on him. You see, the same way you look in the life of Apostle Paul, he was chasing the Son of God. He wants to kill them. In all these things, God still teaching him a lesson. He said, what I'm trying to tell you here is this. If you are not being disciplined, you are an illegitimate son or daughter. See? And that is why the Bible says all of us need to go through trials and preparation. He said, you ask yourself, and have you ever seen any teacher? Unless that teacher have to teach you, he must have a broken heart. You see, and that is why this brings me to the step two. You see, the step two is patience. Do you have patience in your life? You see, we like to give our children them patience. We name them patience. Why? Because we receive it from the word of God that it's a good thing to give. You see, maybe your parents have gone through a lot. Maybe they were patient and they are waiting for the baby, and then the baby comes there. It's okay. Your name is patient because I waited patiently. You see, today I want you to see that patience in the way, because the Bible says, rejoice in your suffering. Know that your suffering produces what? Endurance. So that endurance is what is giving you the Christian character. You want the Christian character today, you can receive it. And for you to receive it, you need to receive Jesus Christ. Amen? Because then the pressure, you need to do what? Pressure comes, and then you have to be patient in it, you see? So in other words, God is telling you today that for you to have that quality life that you are seeking what? In Christ, Jesus Christ, you need to welcome trouble. You need to welcome pressure. You need to welcome heartbroken. You see, because the Bible wants to develop your character. You see, and the Bible called that character patience, perseverance, consistency, endurance. You see, so you think, are you looking for a way to escape when you go through trials and temptation? I'm telling you today, don't do it. You need to go through it, because that's only way you're going to be purified. That's only way God's going to know who you are. You see, God wants to trust me, God wants to trust you, but the only way you can do that is to do what? To test you. So there's no point in dropping out or quitting. Some people will just want to give up. You see, don't have that strong faith. Some people think they can do it by their own willpower. I see some people think it is by strength. The Bible tells me and you, it's not by strength, it's not by mind, by the Spirit, says the Lord. And that is why today I'm telling you to do what? To have patience with God. Amen. The only thing you need to do, just simply endure. Amen. Just endure when you go through trials, because your character needs to do what? To be built up. You want to have a Christian character, not worldly character. If you want to have a Christian character, you must accept Jesus Christ. That is the first step, because you need that foundation. And then you remember that any stone that must stand with Jesus Christ, when you build that building, the Bible says when the winds and the storm and all the same come, the Bible says that you become a fool, because why? It didn't build it in a solid foundation. And that foundation is Jesus Christ. That's why the Bible said that you need to be rooted, you see? So that brings me to what? To my third step is purity. Everything needs to go through fire. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can't consume ever for excuses, but at the same time, he needs to put you through fire to see what you have been made of. Whether you've been made of God or you've been made of wood. Because if you have been made of wood, you know what can happen to the wood? The wood catches fire. I mean, Peter says this in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 7. He said to me that your faith will be like gold that has been tested in the fire, being refined and by refiner until it is pure. So he's speaking about trials. That's what he's trying to say. He said that your faith has to be proven to show how much your faith is, you see? Because that faith needs to go through fire. And when you come out from it, you come out from it, you're going to do what? You're going to produce pressure. You're going to produce pure character. Amen? So that means when sometimes when the wind blows, you're going to stand still. And that is why the word of God is telling you today, see, because you're trying to be provoked through what, two trials and temptations, so that you can produce what? Experience, perseverance, endurance. So God just do what? God just shoot out the shaft that you don't need to be there. You ask any good gospel, then know when the God is already ready. Because that God is going to reflect the image. You're going to reflect the image. The same way God wants to reflect his image in your life. And that is why you need to go through fire. You see, remember when Apostle Paul said that as you are continuing to walk with God, as you continue to look at his face, the Bible says you're going to transform like him. And then you ask any good couples, you know, they are just one. He knows what he's taking, he knows what she's taking. They are just one. You see, you are walking in one step.
Amen.
The same way God wants to meet your character, the same way God wants to walk with you. And then you don't have to walk against God, you have to walk with God. When that pressure is being put on you, when you've been squeezed, you see, God wants to see that oil coming out.
Amen.
Look at the olive oil, they squeeze it, they put pressure on it, and then the olive oil start producing good oil. And that's why today you are enjoying and cooking with it. But the same way God wants to see that oil, and then he wants to see that Holy Spirit that is in you, and directing you to live the way that he wants you to live, you see. Many of you today don't understand this, right? Because you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Pastor. So I want you today to do what? To make up your mind today. Because when all said and done, you're going to be tested, you see? And that's why Peter was trying to tell you early today. The many of us today don't understand one thing. I want you to understand you need to go through pain. You need to go through hell. You need to have this pressure. You need to have persuasion. You need to have misunderstanding. The women in all these things, God is trying to train you up. I mean, you ask Job, I mean, me and you today, we can never say we have come to the point where we have suffered like Job. Job lost everything. He lost all his children. He lost everything that he had. But then again, you see the word Job said, you look at Job, like I told you today, last night. He said that he knows the way that I take. He's talking about God, and God knows the way he takes. He said that when he had tried me, I should come out as a goat. So what is he trying to tell you here? The Bible is telling that Job was tested, and he knows that God is testing him. And then when he comes up from the other side of him, he's going to be pure as gold. Just as the goldsmith had to pull that gold through the iron and to refine it. The same way God is testing your character. The same way God wants to prove your character. God wants to know that are you a child of God? Because it's easier to say I'm a child of God, and then again, you're not living it out. You see, that is why I want you today to do what? To open two of your hands, as God has opened his hands, say, let all come to him. And he said, those who have been led that he will give you rest. The same way, open your hands when you have trials. Let that trial take its place, because if that trial don't take its place, that means you don't know who you are in Christ Jesus. Your faith must be tested, you see. And that is why today I want you, as you are working with God, I mean, even Malachi said the same thing, book of Malachi 3 verse 3. He said that he will sit as a refiner and preferer of the silver, and God, he will prepare the sons of Levi and refine them just like gold and silver. I mean, so he's talking about sons of Levi, he's talking about the priest. I'm a priesthood. Every one of us here is a priesthood. Do you know that all of us here are working around your priesthood? You see, you can count yourself out, but God never counts you out. Amen. God never can't. God's gonna test your character. Your character is gonna be tested, whether you like it or not. You're gonna be tested. God wants to see if you're being made of gold or wood. You see. So today I want you to put your faith on the finished work of Jesus Christ. I want you to accept that treasure. It. Don't turn it outside when you go to prayers, and that brings you to the word. My fourth point. The first step is what? And now the Bible says in the book of the same Romans chapter 5 verse 4, it says character produces soul. So God now have to come and give you that fourth quality that you need to have. And then if you don't have hope, then that means you are finished. And then some of you, before the Christmas, you are hoping that your parents are going to give you gift. And obviously it comes to pass, isn't it? So the same way today, I want you to put your hope in God, Jesus Christ. Amen. Put your hope in him, amen. Because if you don't put your hope, you have to remember hope is not like I wish or I desire. That's not hope. You see, hope is a solid foundation based on the word of God. Because the Bible says the word of God is here and ever. The Bible says that heaven and earth shall pass away, but his word cannot pass away. Do you know why? Because the Bible says the word of God is God. And then we should say that, I give you my word, you should take me by my word, isn't it? That's what we used to say here. You say your word is your bond, isn't it? You say where the word of God is here and amen. All the promises that's in the word of God is here and amen. And I want you today to do what? To accept God by his word, you see? Because when you have hope, outside hope, you're gonna have, if you don't have hope, you're gonna just walk like a shark in this world. And then when you end up your life, you don't know who trust Christ, you see? But if you have your hope in God, the Bible says that the hope that you put in him will never put us into what? Into shame, you see? And that is why today, if you want to have hope, you need to know that our God is a faithful God. Our God never fails, you see it too. Apostle Paul says similar thing in the book of Romans chapter 8, verse 38. He said, for I know so that neither death nor life, nor angel nor rulers, nor the things present, nor the things to come, nor powers, nor height or depth, nor anything else in creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
What a wonderful statement. And in fact, let me tell you something. I don't feel like going wrong with this kind of, with this kind of statement, you see, because he's telling that nothing can separate me. And he's saying that same thing. I'm saying it as well. She's saying it. All of us saying the same thing. Why? Because we know that the word of God is true. Nothing can separate me from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Because you can see how happy I am. When I sometimes come through the word of God, you just kind of understand that it's so pure and real. Because the Bible is saying today, friends, the hope means what? Let me put it this way. When you have hope, you know that you are hoping for something. The Bible says that faith is a substance of something that you hope for, evidence of things that not been seen. So if you have hope in God today, all these things are, God bless you, children, the man blessed. So the Bible is saying today, if you have hope in Jesus Christ today, just as Apostle Paul said in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 19, he said, if only this time that you are living have hope in Christ, the Bible is saying that me and you should be pitied. Amen. But you know that the hope that we have is beyond this life. That is why I'm coming out to preach to you. Let me tell you, if I don't have hope in this life, if I don't have hope where I'm going, you won't see me in this cold weather. You know? But I come here, why? Because I know my hope is in God. Amen? And I know there's a reward for me. You see? And the same way today, your time I need to do what? To be tested, you see? But the opposite of hope is devil. When I try to blow away that candle of faith, of hope, of perseverance, or endurance in your life, you see? And that is why the Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 2, verse 12, he says some people are living because they don't have hope. And if you don't have hope, that means you don't know Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ is hope, Jesus Christ is faith, Jesus Christ is perseverance, Jesus Christ is endurance, Jesus Christ is good character. Amen. That is the whole thing. When we look at the life of Jesus Christ, I cannot compare myself to him. You cannot compare yourself to him. Why? Because he lived without sin. He was sinless. Amen. And that is why you can look up onto him and say, okay, I want to be like him. Because I can help myself. Amen. And if you say you can't help yourself, and then you ask him to come and help you, he gives you that Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, God bless you, man. He gives that Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will lead you to do what? To glorify the name of God. That is why the Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 1, verse 6, it says, he will start a good work in your life, will bring it to completion on the day of our Lord Jesus. Amen. And that is why I'm telling you today. What a wonderful thing to serve the living God.
Amen.
What a wonderful thing to serve the Almighty God. Because the Bible says that our faith, our hope, our life is not only in this place. Amen. We have a destination that we need to go at the end of the day. You see? And that is why I'm telling you today. Give your life to Jesus Christ today, not tomorrow. Give your life to Jesus, because if you don't give your life to Jesus Christ today, tomorrow may never come for some of you. Amen. I don't have guarantee that I can live to tomorrow. Likewise, you see, and that is why when the Bible says today is the day of salvation, not tomorrow, and then that God wants you to do what? To change today. That's why the Bible says, pray for God and hearing the word of Jesus Christ. And that is why I come here to preach to you. I come here and say that you can give your life to God. Because if you don't give your life to God, you cannot make it into the kingdom of God. And if you don't have God, you don't have Jesus Christ, you can never have a Christian, you can never have a Christian character. And my message to you today is to have a Christian character. In the name of Christ, in the mighty